हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस इज़ ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ फिज़िक्स, क्लास मैट्रिक फिज़िक्स। आई एम योर फिज़िक्स टीचर सोफिया शाकिर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फिज़िक्स। हेलो यस स्टूडेंट्स, सो व्हाट इज़ फिज़िक्स? फिज़िक्स इज़ द वर्ड फिज़िक्स कम्स फ्रॉम अ ग्रीक वर्ड फिज़िकोस मीनिंग नेचर। स्टूडेंट्स, एवरी वन थॉट डैट फिज़िक्स इज़ अ डल सब्जेक्ट और फिज़िक्स इज़ अ बोरिंग सब्जेक्ट, बट इट्स नॉट करेक्ट। फिज़िक्स इज़ अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट एंड वी आर लिविंग इन नेचर एज फिज़िक्स इज़ द स्टडी ऑफ नेचर। इफ़ यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी नेचर दैन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फिज़िक्स। ओके, so if you are taking the simple example of a nature that the solar system is the most important and most common example of nature. In solar system, the earth revolves around the sun and every planet revolves around the sun, but the question that comes in our mind that why the planets and why the earth and other planets are revolved in orbit, why they are revolving around the sun, why they are not moving in a linear path. So all type of these questions, physics give us the answers of all type of these questions. So if we are studying physics, if we are studying nature, then it is the study of physics that how physics is called the boring subject. And from the very first day when Allah has created this universe, Allah says in Quran Pak innama amruhu idha wa'ada shay'an ay yakula lahu kun fayakun. Allah Rabbul Alamin create this whole universe with only a single word be. With only Allah Pak ne sari duniya ko takhleeq kiya kun ke word se. And from the very first day everything followed the rules of Allah Rabbul Alamin. The sun sets at time, the sun rises at time, the sun falls at time, the moon comes at night in the sky. So कभी आपने देखा है कि सूरज देर से ग़ुरूब हुआ हो या सूरज देर से तुलू हुआ हो? कभी आपने ये देखा है कि दिन में चांद नज़र आता है? नहीं। सो एवरी थिंग फॉलोज द रूल्स ऑफ अल्लाह रब्बुल आलमीन एंड दीज आर कॉल्ड लॉज ऑफ नेचर। एंड इफ़ यू हैव स्टडीड दीज लॉज ऑफ नेचर देन इट इज़ व्हाट? इट इज़ फिज़िक्स। सो व्हाट इज़ द फिज़िक्स? बेसिकली फिज़िक्स इज़ द ब्रांच ऑफ साइंस इन विच वी स्टडी अबाउट मैटर एंड एनर्जी। इट मीन्स दैट व्हाट इज़ मैटर? Everything that has space and occupy volume, that is called matter. And if energy, if we are studying the matter and energy, and if we are studied the interaction between them, then it is what? It is physics. Okay, in other words, we can say that physics is concerned with energy and have its effect the natural world. Okay, physics is the students, physics is the fundamental branch of science, and the physics is divided into main branches. The main branches of physics are given as below. First branch of physics is called mechanics. Okay, so it deals with the motion of an object with or without reference of force. So if we are studied the motion of an object, so we are studied, we are dealing with the branch of physics that is called mechanics. Just like if we are kicking a football, agar hum ek football ko kick karte hain, so which type of a motion it occurs? Is it occurs projectile motion? Is it occurs linear motion? Is it occurs circular motion? So all these are categorized in mechanics. So we can say that mechanics is the branch of physics that deal with the motion of an object. Now second branch of physics is called electricity. So electricity is concerned with the phenomena and effects that is related to the electric charges. If we have studied about electrical charges, then it is related with electricity. Understand, student? Now third branch of physics is electromagnetism. Deals with observation principles, laws and methods that relate with the electricity and magnetism. We already have done various experiments in class 6, in class 7, in class 8 about electricity and magnetism. So there is a deep relationship between electricity and magnetism, and if we have studied these things, then we are categorized in electromagnetism. Now other branch of physics is solid state physics. So it is concerned with the structure and properties of solid material. If we are studied about the structure properties of solid material, then it is categorized into solid state physics. Number 5 branch of physics is atomic physics. It is concerned with the structure and properties of an atom. So students, atom has electrons that are revolving around the orbit and protons are in the center of the orbit. Just like if you are taking the example of helium. So helium is an atom. Okay, so if you have studied the helium atom, then it is categorized, or other type of elements or other type of atoms, then it is categorized into atomic physics. Now, sixth branch of physics is nuclear physics. Nuclear physics is deals with the structure, properties and reactions of the nuclei of an atom. We know that every atom has inside a nucleus, and nucleus have proton and neutron in it. So if we are deeply studied about proton and neutron, then it is a study of physics. It is categorized into nuclear physics. Understand, students. Now, other branch of physics is plasma physics. It is concerned with the structure and properties of highly ionized atoms. Okay, so the highly ionized atoms, if you have studied the these highly ionized atoms, then they are related with the plasma physics. Biophysics, it is concerned with the application of physical methods and explanation to biological system and structures. If you are taking, if the biological process that are applied in physics, then they are related with the biophysics. Astrophysics, student, it is concerned with the study of physics and astronomical properties. It means that if you are studied these things, if you are studied about solar system, if you are studied about planets, if you are studied about sun, if you are studied about moon, then all they are connected with the astrophysics. They are categorized in astrophysics. Understand, students. Now memorize these notes carefully, and these are the 9 most important branches of physics. Understand, students. Okay, Allah Hafiz.